splendid day.
Don't be calling James's coaches. Sweet cause the passenger case behaved well.
The passengers even stopped grumbling. But the engines didn't like having to bustle about. There are two ways of doing things, Doc told him. The Great Western way, or the drunk way. I'm Great Western and don't you know it? The engines were mad when the visitor came.
Delightful too, said Duck.
The silly engines were flattered. He has very good manners, they murmured. We are pleased to have him in our yard. Duck had his doubts. Come on, he said. Diesel purred after him. You're with Duck. Sir Topham hat to you, ordered Duck. Diesel looked hurt. Your worthy Sir Topham Hatt thinks I need to learn. He is mistaken. We Diesels don't need to learn. We know everything. We come to a yard and improve it. We are revolutionary. Oh, said Duck, if you're Rever Thingamy, perhaps you would collect my cars while I fetch Gordon's coaches. Diesel, delighted to show off, purred away. When Duck returned, Diesel was trying to take some cars from a siding. They were old and empty. They had not been touched for a long time. Diesel found them hard to move. Pull! Push! Backwards! Forwards! Owie! Owie!
Gasped the cars. Groaned.
We can't! We won't! Duck watched with interest. Diesel lost patience.
Gasped.
Gave a great heave. The cars jerked forward. Oh, oh! They screamed. We can't. We won't. Some of their brakes snapped, and the gear jammed in the sleepers. Arrgh! Oh! Ho, ho, ho! Chuckled Duck. Diesel recovered and tried to push the cars back.
Listen, we won't move.
Duck run quietly round to collect the other cars.
You like me to explain?
I must go now.
No, then James the Duck.
This lot? No, thank you. Diesel gulped, and I... In all this trouble, why didn't you tell me? Thomas felt depressed. Workmen propped up the house with strong poles and laid rails through the garden. Then the Scottish twin engines, Donald and Douglas, arrived.
Don't fash yourself, Thomas. We'll soon have you back on the rails, they laughed. Managed to haul Thomas back to safety.
Bits of fencing, the bush, and a broken window frame festooned his front, which was badly twisted. The twins laughed and left him.
And you laughed, Donald and Douglas.
Thomas was in disgrace. Percy worked hard at the new harbor. Workmen needed stone for their building. Toby helped, but sometimes the loads of stone were too heavy, and Percy had to fetch them for himself.
Sometimes he'd see Thomas. Well done, Percy. Sir Topham Hatt is very pleased with us. An airfield was close by. Percy heard the aeroplane zooming overhead all day.
The noisiest was Harold the helicopter. He had rotor blades.
Stupid thing, said Percy.
Why can't he go and buzz somewhere else?
One day, Percy stopped at the airfield. Hello, said Percy. Who are you?
Dipsy spilled tubby custard all over his tubby seat.
Look, he had an accident, too.
About me and made Sir Topham Hatt and all the engines think I'm horrid. Edward smiled. I know you aren't, and so does Sir Topham Hatt. You wait and see. Why don't you help me with these cars? Duff felt happier with Edward and set to work at once.
Edward was shunting freight cars.
The cars were silly, heavy, and noisy. The two engines had to work hard, pushing and pulling all afternoon. At last, they reached the top of the hill. Goodbye, whistled Duck, and rolled gently over the crossing to the other line. Duck loved coasting down the hill, running easily with the wind whistling past. Suddenly, it was the conductor's warning whistle. Hurrah, 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 laughed the cars. We've broken away. Chase him, bump him, throw him off the rails, they yelled. Hurry, Duck, hurry, said the driver. They raced through Edward Station, but the cars were catching up. As fast as we can, then they'll catch us gradually. The driver was gaining control. Another clear mile and we'll do it. Oh, glory, look at that. James was just pulling out on their line from the station ahead. Any minute there could be a crash. It's up to you now, Duck, cried the driver. Duck put every ounce of weight and steam against the cars.
It's too late, groaned Duck.
And shut his eyes. He veered into a side where a barber had set up shop. He was shaving a customer. Silly cars had knocked their conductor off his van and left him far behind after he had whistled a warning. But the cars didn't care. They were feeling very pleased with themselves. Beg pardon, sir, gasped Duck. Excuse my intrusion. No, I won't, said the barber. You frighten my customers. I'll teach you. And he lathered Duck's face all over. Duck. Thomas was helping to pull the cars away when Sir Topham Hatt arrived. I do not like engines popping through my walls, fumed the barber. I appreciate your feelings, said Sir Topham Hatt, but you must know that this engine and his crew have prevented a serious accident. It was a very close shave. Oh, said the barber. Oh, excuse me. He filled a basin of water to wash Duck's face. I'm sorry. I didn't know you were being a brave engine. That's all right, sir. I didn't know that either.
Edward came to rescue Duck.
Certainly.
No way.
I like my rails, thank you. I think railways are slow, said Harold. They're not much use and quite out of date.
No way.
He whirled his arms and buzzed away.
Look at flight. Airplanes did too.
Percy
should be in here when we get to the quarry.
I say, Toby, that Harold, that stuck-up whirlybird thing, says I'm slow and out of date. Just let him wait.
I'll show him. He collected his freight cars and started off, still fuming.